All right. So today your concept is break statement and continue statement. Right? Clear? Break statement. Yesterday when I was discussing the program of prime number, there I use the break keyword, break statement. Break statement is used to make pre-jump from the loop. The loop is not terminated normally. Loop is still left. Condition is still true. Condition doesn't get false. In spite of this fact, we came out of the loop. Normal execution is loop terminates successfully by reaching the last value in the sequence. And as the loop reaches the last value, loop terminates and we come out of the loop. But when we use the break statement, we make a pre-jump out from the loop, irrespective condition in the loop is still true. But we have forced to come out of the loop. How to use the break? I'll make a very small code in front of you, and from there you can make out what is the role of break statement. For x in range 1, 10. X in range 1, 10. I just increase the size. Is it visible now clearly? Okay. So I have taken the for loop x in range 1:10. Okay. As per this range I have taken, what values will be printed? 1 to 9. If there is only 10, then 0 to 9. If x modulus 5 equal to 0, break, else print x print loop ends. Now, as per this logic, the condition is that x in range 1 to 10 come inside the loop. Modulus every value of for loop with 5, where the number get divisible by 5, break, come out of the loop, don't go ahead. If condition is not true, we will print the value of x. We will print the value of x. Okay, got it? So I make one folder in the desktop, plus one programs 2021, plus one break one. Check the output. Online class, check the output. Okay. Yes, am I clear to all? Tarun, Himanshu, Diya. Am I clear? Totally. I explain how this result has come. X, first of all, is 1. 1 modulus 5 is not equal to 0. If condition fail, break nahi chala, else pe aajaiye, X print karo 1. Then X get increment to 2. 2 modulus 5 not equal to 0. Again condition fails, print X. Then 3, then 4. When X becomes 5, 5 modulus 5 is 0. If condition get true, if condition get true, then break is encountered. Okay? Clear? As soon as break is encountered, we come out of the loop. We come out of the loop body. This is the loop body. All the statements which are indented, they are the part of loop. The statement which is unindented means it is not the part of loop. So when break is encountered, program is not terminated. Only the loop get terminated. We are still in the program. We come here, the very next statement outside the loop. Role of break is clear, online class. Tarun, Himanshu, Diya. Offline class. Because X to be print after else. X to be print after else. Clear? Got it? Yes. Depend if you have taken any condition or not. That depends. Right? Okay. Now, the next concept here, I make save a duplicate copy of this. Plus one. Continue. Continue is also a jumping statement, but instead to terminate the loop, it terminates the iteration of the loop. Loop successfully get complete. Loop successfully gets run till the condition become false. When we are using continue. Achha, break mein aapne ek cheez dekhi. Abhi loop fail nahi hua tha. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, up till 9. These iterations were still left. Loop was still left. Loop condition didn't get failed, but we had a pre-jump. Contrary to it, in continue statement, loop will reach till end. When loop condition will get failed, we will come out of the loop. But continue skip some iterations of the loop. It ignores some iteration and continue with other iteration. I just show you here. If I modulus 3 continue, else print X. Now 1 to 9, where number is divisible by 3, ignore that iteration, consider rest of the iterations. Am I clear, online class? Yes. All right. Check it out. Check the output. 1, 2, 3 modulus 3 0 3 get skipped 3 skip ho gaya online class 4 5 then 6 6 modulus 3 again 0 it get eliminated 7 8 then 9 9 modulus 3 again 0 it also get eliminated so role of continue is clear yes online class manjot yashika kavya divanshi break and continue are thoroughly clear to all of you bete kavya yashika Briti, Nidhi, Arshdeep, Yuvraj. Quickly give your feedback, all of you. Yuvraj Singh, 44, roll number. Mannat, Mayank, Prabhdeep Kaur. Prabhdeep Kaur. Ramanjeet, Jatin, Yuvraj, Virdi. Harshvardhan, Gursirat, wait, all right, now in front of you, I'll be making today a program which run as per the user choice. Till now, whatever programs you have done, they were running for single time. Suppose I want to run the program of prime number up till my wish. Again and again, program should prompt me, enter the number, enter the number. Do you want to run again? Yes, I want to run again. Only when I say no, the program should stop working. This is called user choice program. Okay. And it will be helpful in your project work. So pay attention very carefully for the program. Prime number up till the user's choice. Right. First of all, what we are to do, I am to take a variable CH. You can take, please first see the projector. Take a variable CH, any variable you can take and initialize it with Y. You can take capital Y or small Y as per your convenience. You can take any other value also apart from Y. For me, Y means yes. Y means yes. Since Y is character, I have enclosed it in single quotes. Am I clear? Online class, am I clear? Why I have taken Y? All right. While CH equal to Y in lowercase, or CH equal to Y in upper case. Jab tak aap Y upper ya Y lower keyboard se press karte rahoge, Y loop true rahega. Whenever you will give the value of CH, Y, yes, whether Y in lower case, whether Y in upper case, it will continue. The loop will continue working. Okay. Now I am inside the while loop block. Here, ask the user to enter the number. Right? Am I clear, online class? Set the limit. As I discussed yesterday, prime number, we are to go till half of the number. Agar main 36 ko prime check kar raha hu, to main 18 tak jaunga. Agar main 23 ko check kar raha hu, to main 11.5, yani 11 tak jaunga. Okay? Am I clear? So how to find the half of the number? By dividing the number by 2. Floor division 2. Why I have taken floor division? Why not simple division? In order to avoid the decimal portion, right? Okay. Now here I add 1. Why I have added 1? Suppose my half is 12. Okay. If I will take limit value in for loop, it will go till 11. So I have to go one step ahead. You can take limit plus 1 in for loop also. I have initially taken it, right? For x in range 2 to limit 1 is neither prime nor composite. So we are ignoring 1. I am starting my loop from 2. Okay. Suppose I am going to check for number 16. So 16 ka half kya ho gaya? 16 divided by 2, which is 8. If in for loop I take 2, 8, it will go 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8 to aayega hi nahi. For that, what I have to do, I have to set the limit plus 1. Now limit is 9. Now it will cover all the possible range. Is the reason clear why limit plus 1 has been done? But in some cases, we have to check all the numbers. Like 19, you have to check till end. Where the number is even, at first stage only, you will get to know when it divides by 2. But when the number is odd, suppose 19 number is there. Okay, 19 doesn't come in any table. 15 is odd, but it comes in table of 3. So it is not prime number. For few numbers, you have to check entire range. Okay. Now, after this for loop, when we come here, we are to divide our number with every possible value of x. We are to modulus our number with every possible value of x. X will have values starting from 2 till half of the number. Right? Now remainder comes in R. If R is equal to 0, agar remainder 0 hai, that means number is not prime. There we will do break. Suppose 24. 24 ka half ho gaya 12. 2 se leke 12. 24 modulus 2. First value pe hi wo prove ho gaya. To mujhe aage jaane ki koi zarurat hi nahi hai. I don't want to go further because at the very first stage, it get proved that 24 is not prime. So I will break, I will come out of the loop. Okay. In case now this is else of loop. This is else of loop. Okay. Right. Print number is prime. Right. Clear. Now here you have to ask the user one question. Want to continue running the code?
Yes oblique no.
Whatever value of CH you will enter from the keyboard, that value will be match over here. If your value matches, this code will run again. If your value doesn't matches, the code will not run again. It will stop. Okay? User choice prime. Enter the number. I just quit this window. I open the window again. I open the fresh window so that you people can see output clearly. Enter number 4. Number is not prime. Do you want to continue? Yes. Enter the number 12. Number is not prime. Do you want to continue? Yes. Enter the number 19. Number is prime. Do you want to continue? No. Program stops. Program stops. No further execution will take place. Program stop there and there only. Because I have stopped the choice. I have restricted the choice now. I don't want to run further. Am I clear? Raise your hand for the questions. Wait. I again show the coding to you people. Check it out carefully. If you have any queries, feel free to ask me. Don't hesitate to ask questions. Try to increase your programming skills. Recording is going on. Don't give unusual comments. Wake up, Aryaman. Yes, online class, user's choice code is clear. This will help you in your project work because your project should be up till the user's choice. Pardon? That message you can print by coming out of the body of the while loop. You can message here where the cursor is blinking over here. That you can type here. Okay. Yes. Samriddhi, any doubt? Riddhi. Arshpreet. Asis, sorry. Dhruv Sonic, any doubt? Gurjot, Aryaman, Arshdeep, Japan, Ashutosh. Dia, any questions? Okay. Now I create one more menu driven program. Okay. All right. Here, first of all, we are to generate the menu. Formatting is up to you. How you format your project, how you format the code, that is entirely dependent on your creativity. Okay. here set the menu first. Like I am giving first option as reverse of a number. My second option is sum of digits of a number. My third option is table of a number. Right? This is my menu. Okay? So here I close. You can keep checking side by side your project as and when you are creating it. Like this is the way your menu will appear. I just changed the window. This is the way your menu driven will appear. The starting section of your project. Your complete menu should be visible first. When complete menu is visible, then you will ask the user about your choice. Now, when after this menu, your group member name should also be visible like this. Members of the project. All the three names must be visible. And this entire formatting, ye maine hash lagaye hain. You can use any other special characters. Creativity is up to you. But don't do it over. कि सिर्फ सिंबल ही सिंबल है, ओवर मत करना कुछ, ठीक है? Now here, take a variable ch, give the value y lower or upper, while ch equal to lower y or ch equal to uppercase y. Clear? Am I clear with it? Now here, ask the user choice. Enter the choice. I have taken a choice variable of type integer because my choices are 1, 2, 3. So I am signifying choice with 1, 2, 3 values. Right? If choice equal to 1, if choice equal to 1, that means user prefers to run reverse of a number, right? Now for reverse of a number, you need to input a number. You need to input the number, okay? And transfer the number to a temporary variable. Clear? Time is getting up. I quit my lecture over here. I'll continue further.